Prime Minister, Mr. Kyriakos Mitsotakis, and I'm really happy that Lithuania and Greece are like-minded countries in respect of the EU agenda, and we're cooperating very intensely in order to reinforce both security and stability in Europe. I would like, first of all, to use this occasion to thank the Prime Minister personally and also all of Greece for the help that Lithuania, that they provided Lithuania last year when we were confronted to the hybrid attacks of the Lukashenko's regime using illegal migration. This was a point where we really could, or actually the Greek institutions shared their broad experience and counsels with us, and we got very much support and very much technical support as well.
Well, thank you, Prime Minister, for this very warm welcome and the productive discussions that we had, and it's a great pleasure to be able to visit Lithuania, particularly as this year we celebrate the centennial of the diplomatic relations between our two countries. Relations which are becoming even stronger, as highlighted by frequent and productive visits at all levels. And I think the development of our close relations comes rather naturally, given, you know, lots of similarities between our two countries. And despite our geographical distance, Greece and Lithuania face common challenges, such as revisionist threats, the energy crisis, the weaponization of migration, which you referred. But we also share the same European values and principles, and a firm commitment to upholding respect for international law, human rights, and the sovereignty and territorial integrity of all countries. We discussed, of course, the blatant Russian invasion into Ukraine, violating the UN Charter, completely disregarding the rules-based international order, and we reaffirmed our commitment to stand by Ukraine along with the rest of our EU partners and all, at least all but one, NATO allies against this aggression. We discussed in detail the latest development in Ukraine, the next steps we should take. We again condemned in the strongest possible terms Russia's latest indiscriminate missile and drone attacks on Ukrainian cities, resulting in the death of innocent civilians and the destruction of critical infrastructure. And we continue to fully support Ukraine's independence, sovereignty, and territorial integrity. We will stand with Ukraine for as long as it takes, and we shall continue to provide not just politically, but also financial, military, and humanitarian support to the Ukrainian people. I had the opportunity to also brief the Prime Minister on the situation in the Eastern Mediterranean and the continuous tensions provoked by Turkey in the Aegean, and through actions and an escalatory rhetoric that unfortunately undermines the stability and security in the whole region. I think here again we see a case of how a revisionist rhetoric can undermine regional stability at a time when the last thing we need is another source of tension in the Eastern Mediterranean, especially between two NATO allies. As I've repeatedly undermined, Greece always, Prime Minister, maintains an open window for dialogue, but we keep the door firmly shut to challenges and threats, especially when those pertain to our national sovereignty. And unfortunately, as regards the Russian war of aggression against Ukraine, Turkey considers that it does not need to choose aside, as if there is no right or wrong. Seems to be okay for Turkey to be providing arms for Ukraine while accommodating Russia's economic interest and disregarding EU sanctions. And I think we need to make sure we've done so at the level of the European Council to call upon all countries, especially those countries that aspire, at least in words, to become members of the European family, to align themselves with the decisions we have taken. As we've discussed, sanctions do work. They impose a heavy penalty on the Russian economy. And the more we tighten the screws on those countries that facilitate Russia to bypass the sanctions, the more effective the sanctions that we have imposed will be. As the Prime Minister said, we've also discussed the most complicated and difficult question regarding the weaponization of energy by Russia, especially the very high gas prices. And I'm very happy that we have worked very closely with Lithuania, both at our level but also at the level of our ministers of energy, in coming up with very specific and concrete solutions that can help us bring down the price of gas to acceptable levels. And my hope is that these measures will be agreed at the level of the ministers of energy in order to reduce the pressure that we all face in terms of providing support for businesses and households from our budget. We are all doing that. We all spend a significant amount of money, a significant percentage of our GDP, to provide support. But a European solution has been long in my mind, has been long overdue. And this is really the time to send a very clear signal both to Russia but also to the markets that speculation in the gas market will be addressed in a unified manner by the European Union by imposing some sort of cap on the TTF index, as we've discussed by now in excruciating detail, even at our level, at the level of heads of state and government. Last but not least, both Lithuania and Greece face similar challenges when addressing the problem of weaponizing migrants to put political pressure on our countries. We have a very good and strong cooperation in the field of migration, and I think we always need to make the case that we cannot in principle accept the fact that desperate people are being used, are being weaponized for political purposes. Greece will continue to defend its borders, which are also the borders of the European Union, always ready to offer humanitarian support to people, especially people whose lives are in danger at sea. And we will always call on our neighbors, especially Turkey, to cooperate constructively to address this problem. And in that respect, I think we have lots in common in terms of designing our approach when it comes to border management and border security. Prime Minister, thank you again for the very warm welcome to Vilnius.